the interval 0 to 2. It will be given by 2 by L integral over 0 to L f of x cos n pi x by L. So now you substitute the value of L. So 2 by 2 into integral over 0 to 2. F of x value in the interval 0 to 2 is x. So just to substitute that value, cos n pi x by 2 into dx. So now it will become 2, 2 will get cancelled. The remaining thing will become integration over 0 to 2 x cos n pi x by 2 dx. So now you have to apply UV rule, that is Bernoulli's rule. So first function is x and second function is cos n pi x by 2. So x into integration of this one is sin n pi x by 2 into the constant is n pi by 2 will get in the denominator. If you shift into numerator, it will become 2 by n pi minus derivative of x is 1 and integration of this one will become minus cos n pi x by 2 into 2 square by n square pi square. So where the limits varies from 0 to 2. So if you put the limits means this sine function will be 0. That's why I'm going to apply only for the second term. So second term minus into minus will become plus. So constant is 2 square by n square pi square. I'm going to take that 2 square by n square pi square outside. If you took that one outside means just to put upper limit 2 in place of x. If you put x equals 2 means 2, 2 will get cancelled. Remaining thing is cos n pi. So now if you put x equals 0 means the whole thing will become 0, that is cos 0. So cos n pi value we know, that is minus 1 raised to n, and cos 0 value is minus 1. So that will become 4 by pi square into minus 1 raised to n minus 1 divided by n square. So now we have to substitute these two values a naught and an in the equation star. So a naught value is 2, 2 by 2 means it will become 1 plus 4 by pi square, it's not having n terms. Whichever not having n terms, you can take it out. So because we are going to expand that one about n. So now remaining thing, whatever the terms are having n, you have to write it inside. Minus 1 raised to n minus 1 divided by n square into cos n pi x by 2. So now by putting n equals 1, 2, 3, you can expand this one in terms of series. Otherwise, leaving at this step also, that's also fine only. This is the required cosine series of the function f of x in the interval 0 to 2. Is it clear to all of you? Anybody is having doubt? So quickly ask question. I'll try to convey you people and I'll move on to next question. Anybody is having doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Vishwas K. Any doubt, Vishwas?
No, sir.
Okay. So next one, same function. We have to find out the sine series. If you want to find out the sine series, means just you have to take mirror image about the origin. Mirror image about the origin means it will be this portion. This is the portion. Actual portion is this one. If you taken mirror image about the origin means you will get this portion. In case if you are writing in pencil means just to shade these two portion, this portion with this portion. So then you will come to know how to take the mirror image. So f of x equals x, if you taken about the origin means mirror image, so it will be odd function. So odd function means, so if the function is odd, then we know that a naught and an will be zero. That is, f of x will be only having sine function. That is, it will be given by summation bn sin n pi x by l. So where l value is 2, just to substitute that one. So it will become bn sin n pi x by 2. Now we have to find out bn. Bn equals 2 by l integral over 0 to l f of x sin n pi x by l dx. So just to substitute the value of l. 2 by 2 integral over 0 to 2, so x into sin n pi x by 2. Apply the Bernoulli's rule of integration. X into integration of this one will become minus cos n pi x by 2 into 2 by n pi minus derivative of x is 1 into integration of this one will become minus sin n pi x by 2 into 2 square by n square pi square. If you put upper and lower limit, this second term will be 0. So only for the first term you have to put the limits. So minus 2x by n pi into cos n pi x by 2. So just this is a simplification step. So here you see minus 2 by n pi, we can take it out because it is constant. So now you put x equals 2 and 0, it will become, so actually I forgot to consider this x, that's why it's I crossed out little bit. So if you put x equals 2 means it will become 2 into cos n pi upper limit and lower limit will become zero. I forgot this x. That's why I have written it as 1, cos 0 value. So now if you put the value means 2, we can take it out. Minus 4 by n pi into cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n. So now just to substitute, in this one minus 4 by pi is constant, we can take it out. Minus 1 raised to n by n into sin n pi x by 2 is the required sine series in the interval 0, 2 for the function f of x equals x. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then you try to solve the next problem. Oh, I forgot. Just to note down the one problem. Simple only, I'll tell. Find the Fourier series, afferent series, afferent sine series. All of you note down. Find the afferent sine series of the function f of x equals, of the function f of x equals x square, f of x equals x square in the interval, 0 comma pi. The function is f of x equals x square in the interval 0 comma pi. We have to find out sine series. Sine series means just you have to take the mirror image of this curve about the origin. That thing, if you, even if you are not writing the graph of the curve, that's fine. Just to consider f of x equals bn series bn . So since the interval is 0 comma pi, it will become sine nx, where bn will be, two by pi integral over 0 to pi f of x sine nx dx. Just to find out the value of this one. Quickly find out it. Within 5 minutes you should complete. Have you understood what's the half range? At least if you understood the concept, means remaining thing is same only, finding and all. There is no major changes. I hope all of you are solving. And start preparation next Monday, that is on 28th, you will be having first internal. I'm reminding 1 week before only. You should not neglect, and don't think it will be internal will be easy. Definitely it will be difficult. It will not be like last semester.
Sir, it's minus 2 into minus 1 the whole power n by n.
Minus 2 into?
Minus 1 the whole power n by n.
Bn value, huh? No, not right, Karthik. Once you check, the function is...
Sir, minus 2 pi into minus 1 the whole power n by n.
No. Three terms you will get. X square is there, na function.
Yes, sir.
So three terms you should get. One term, whatever you are telling, that's right. But one more term, two more terms you left. Just to check once. The function is X square. Any other answer? In case if you completed, just to tell me answer.
Right. Minus 2 pi into minus 1 minus 1 the whole power n by n minus 2 into minus 1 the whole power n minus 1 by n cube.
Minus. I'll tell Karthik just to cross check. 2 by pi is common. We can keep it outside bn. Okay. Remaining thing is minus pi square into minus 1 raised to n divided by n, first term. Is it matching? Minus pi square?
Yes, sir.
Yes, otherwise, I'll write it on this whiteboard. 1 minute. Two by pi, we can take it out. This is final answer. Bn, I'm telling Bn by pi into minus pi square minus 1 raised to by n plus 2 into minus 1 raised to n by n square minus 2 by n cube. This is the bn value. Is it matching, Ujjwal?
No, sir.
With yes, which term sir. Is miss?
Like science. I got minus 2.
Okay. Somebody was responding. Who's that?
Sir, I got this.
The same thing you got, Trisha?
Yes, same.
Okay. Then answer is right only. Actually, they have given here n cube, second term. It should be n square only. No, this should be n cube only, right? Second term?
Yes, sir, it's n cube.
Sir. Yes, sir.
N cube,
sir.
Yeah,
n cube.
So this afferency, sir, is so easy because only a naught, a n, b n. Yes?
Is any term missed, sir?
No.
Is any term missed?
No.
Like
not
I got minus x square by n.
Minus x square by n cos nx, right?
No, I just got minus x square by n.
Hey, minus x square, how it will be? You are going to put in place of x only pi, na? How x will be there at the end?
Okay. That's zero.
Yeah, so if you put x equals pi means it will become pi square something and lower limit will become zero. So once if you complete, just to tell me, I'll tell one more problem for workout. Then I'll continue in the next class. So attendance still not given, right? So I'll send the link in chat box. So just to give me attendance. Guys, check your chat box and give attendance. Enter attendance in case if you are not had that time. So just to check your chat box and give attendance. completed entire attendance?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just to note down one more problem. Find the half range cosine. Find the half range cosine and half range sine series. Both you have to find out, okay? And half range sine series for the function f of x equals. For the function f of x equals x minus 1 whole square, x minus 1 whole square in the interval 0 less than x less than 1. So just you have to find out separately half range cosine series, and then in the second part you have to find out the half range sine series. Have you noted down problem?
Yes, sir.
Just to note down this much. F of x equals x minus, where the limits varies from 0 to 1. We have to find out both cosine series as well as sine series. Okay. So just to try, in case if you are not getting, I'll discuss this problem in next class. In case if you found, means I'll next move on to next problem. Okay. Is it fine?
Okay, sir.
Okay, guys. Bye. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Okay.